on, I found out that experiences that I had didn't really exist until they were down on paper in a journal. I mean, it was almost as if an experience wasn't complete until it was on paper. So I just kept journals all throughout growing up. A lot of my early writing, when I was trying to figure out how I was going to write a longer work of fiction, tended to be scenes that didn't really, I mean, they set up some sense of character, but they also set up a very, you know, distinct sense of place. So I began working with a sense of place first, and I think my journals tended to be very descriptive in terms of what I was feeling going on around me at the time that this event happened to me. I took a class under Lee Smith. I remember having her comment on one of my my stories, life is messy, fiction can't be. And I realized at that point you can't simply, you know, sort of string together this momentous event, you know, and have it open-ended. You have to rein it into something that has a conflict, a resolution, or something, you know, that will contain it. And I think at that point in college is when I started taking the experiences that I had, and that's when I stopped writing journals also. I started taking the experiences I'd had and then transferring them to a completely different situation and a completely different narrative.